after the tremendous success of Wonder Woman and every Marvel movie, as well as the recent discovery that I had on social media that Thor Ragnarok, apparently they do this for every movie, but they're doing it for Thor Ragnarok, Disney Marvel targets mom vloggers and bloggers to tell families, other moms to go and take their families to see Disney Marvel movies, which explains why they have such huge turnout in that regard. That's amazing. It's no accident. But it's become clear, I think, at this point that families are vital when it comes to the success of comic book movies. And by Jove, I think DC's finally got it, as evidenced by this brand new poster that was released today, which I think is absolutely stunning. And I was shocked to see on social media, as an entertainment reporter, I spend a lot of time on social media trying to, get a bead on what everybody's talking about and what they're saying about it. And I was surprised to see someone say they felt this was the weakest poster yet. And I can understand maybe because I think it's the strongest. And I'm saying that as a DC fan. I can see DC fans saying, no, it's the Alex Ross one, right? And I get that. It's fansational. But I think the importance of that would be lost on a mainstream viewer who was walking in the movie theater, and they have the posters on display, and they'd be like, oh, the DC movies take themselves so seriously. Why so serious? And this one, this just looks like so much fun. The clarity, the color. Who knows if this is going to be reflected in the actual film? They're working really hard on it, down to the wire, and Joss Whedon is, I think, trying to pull it in that direction while still staying faithful to Zack Snyder's vision. It'll be indeed very interesting to see how it turns out. But we saw from the last trailer that at least with the visual effects, when we did those comparison shots, that they have really made the shots more, a lot busier and a lot more colorful and added a little bit of pixie dust to some degree. Let's hope the magic works. But I wanted to talk about this poster and break it down because I think that I wanted to explain why I think it's so good. I think it's very revealing as to what characters are clearly, movie studios do their research. So you can clearly see who's testing well. And I just want to break it down because also I'm just excited about it. All right. So what's interesting to me, fascinating to me, is that Wonder Woman, after so long, Batman dominating everything that has to do with DC, particularly when there's a team, he's put on teams he doesn't belong on, like the recent Justice League Dark animated movie. That was ridiculous. He dominated the advertising for that. But here, Wonder Woman has the top, most prominent position, and she's the only one on the poster looking at the audience. That's amazing to me. She's like, hey, remember how much you liked my movie? I'm back really soon. I mean, that's amazing. It's very rare, except I guess with Iron Man, who's the most ubiquitous. We thought that, Ben Affleck's Batman would be the Iron Man of the DCEU, but I think many of us are believing that it might end up being Gal Gadot. Although Iron Man's no longer the Iron Man of the MCU, as everyone has thrown their allegiance behind Captain America. Although that really hasn't taken effect yet. He doesn't seem to be in Black Panther, which I had fully expected. And I'm surprised by that. I understand why they wouldn't do it. But and also, Chris Evans seems very game to participate, but maybe he's just not as aggressive as Robert Downey Jr., who's very aggressive. But anyway, she's drawing you in here. She looks absolutely amazing. I think that her hair continues to be a problem. It's interesting. I mean, to hear, she very much looks like a Greek warrior. It has a more natural curly quality to it. It's flatter, but, she's doing a lot of action and running around. It's hard to have that perfect salon hair, in the battlefield. So it's interesting to me. I think it's fascinating that this is, I know a lot of you are like, why do you keep talking about hair, Grace? But let me explain it to you. This is a really good way to highlight, we'll talk about Aquaman's highlights when we get to him, but it's a great way to highlight the difference in how male and female filmmakers see a character, right? Zack Snyder, and I'm sure Joss Whedon are like, well, Joss Whedon always gave Black Widow very practical hair, which, sometimes worked, sometimes did not. And it's fascinating, when the Russo brothers do Black Widow, they always give her blowouts. As I say, who's doing blowouts in Avengers Tower? There's no one doing them with the Justice League. That's definitely wash and wear hair on Wonder Woman. So Zack Snyder, I think he's going for a realistic aspect to it. And, again, Joss Whedon goes for realistic. But, Patty Jenkins realizes that, when women see really great hair, they go, ooh, it's really easy. It's an easy way to engage your audience. It's definitely noticed. But I think her pose is great. I think having her sword up against her armband is really fantastic. I think that's one of the best poses I've seen for her in this movie. It's powerful, but yet it doesn't look like she thinks too much of herself. And also, that's totally in the expression. Gal Gadot is an amazing face actor, also like Robert Downey Jr. She's really, really good. Some of the best casting ever. This is like Harrison Ford level casting, you know, in terms of Indiana Jones and Han Solo. So that's something that Zack Snyder did. And he cast everybody here. We talked about that. Zack Snyder is very good at casting, you know, especially here. Then we'll see what her role is like in the movie, though, because I think that she has been downplayed in the trailers. And I think that, again, Zack Snyder doesn't have a good track record when it comes to female characters. I know he has a lot of them, but they're usually eye candy and they're not really there for story purposes. Just look at Watchmen. When they took lines from Silk Spectre and gave it to male characters, even though she was still in the scene. Very frustrating. And Whedon, I think, is going to want to stay clear from that after what happened with Black Widow. He's like, I'm not doing that again. No, thank you. I don't want to mess up my Batgirl opportunity, so let's be careful. Now, I'm absolutely shocked that while Batman isn't the head, in the lead position, I'm shocked that he has such a horrible position. I would even say he has the worst position on this poster. That's amazing. Not just the position, but the angle of his head. He is not engaging. He's almost like, I hope nobody sees me crouched here, you know? Like, I have to be on the poster, but I'm a little, you know, I'd rather not be. And maybe that's how Warner Brothers feels. You know, he's had a rough time. This poster's coming out right after the recent allegations against him by numerous women. And then also, the questions about his future in the franchise will not go away, even though he tries to silence them. Nobody will listen. And also, I think that to be fair, Ben Affleck's strongest contribution to the DCEU is his Bruce Wayne, not his Batman. I'm hoping this movie changes that, but this poster doesn't give me, none of the posters actually have given me tremendous, you know, faith that that will be the case. And I don't know why it's blue. I think because this is trying to, I mean, I like more color. And, I like more color in the Justice League. I think that's a good idea, but not on Batman. That is a step too far. Batman is not a colorful character, all black, all right? And particularly as a New Yorker who likes black themselves, you know, who's partial to wearing all black, that's one of the reasons I like Batman so much. He doesn't wear navy blue. Where were you, Alfred, when he was getting dressed this morning? Now let's move to the Flash. He's the only other one who's sort of looking at the audience. In fact, at first I thought he was, but he's not. But he and Aquaman must be testing through the roof because they have the second best placement after Wonder Woman. And I believe it. I think they're coming across very well in the trailers. Now, I wish there had been more electrical energy emanating off of him, because that's his visual effects. And I interviewed the Justice League visual effects team, and they said that creating his visual effects was their favorite part of doing the VFX on this movie. And you can tell the love crackles through with the energy. So I would have loved to have even more of that, kind of like the Aquaman splash, which is just really a nice touch. That is beautiful. It looks so refreshing. I'm like, I missed some of that over here, Jason Momoa. And boy, talk about color. The green on his costume is really coming through. And the highlights on his hair, he has the best hair. And that scar in his eyebrow, they really made, you know, it's become an asset with him as this character. But the highlights, the way they kind of like match the gold in the uniform, that's just a really nice look. I mean, Wonder Woman standing next to him, she should be like, Aquaman has better hair than me. That should tell me something. Although it would be hard to compete with that. But he just looks absolutely fantastic. They've toned him down. He seems a bit more serious. He doesn't have the aw yeah factor that he's had in the trailers. Maybe, you know, I guess they don't want this to seem too Saturday morning cartoon, although that's working very well for Marvel. But their posters are serious. The expressions are serious there as well. So I think that looks great. And he has the trident at the same angle as Wonder Woman's sword. So that's very nice. And of course, their peoples both have mother boxes, right? So the Amazons from Themyscira and the people of Atlantis, they have a long history together. So it's nice to see them there together. Then as for Cyborg, still the weakest of the group, not only on the poster. Actually, I would say that Batman is still the weakest, but, you know, Cyborg's right behind him. But I think every time somebody looks at Cyborg, they're like, why are you here? And why are you not the Cyborg that we know and love from the Teen Titans, you know, animation? So I think there could be some potential with Ray Fisher and the Man in the Machine storyline they seem to be going with, but it's going to have to really be very moving and interesting to overcome, I think, the disappointment and, again, not having the Teen Titans version of Cyborg and not having Green Lantern. And I'm talking about John Stewart Green Lantern, because that would solve the diversity issue that is, I think, very clearly the reason that Cyborg is on this team. Because he's not supposed to. I've never liked him on the Justice League. I didn't like when they promoted him in the comics. I don't think it's a promotion. I think it's a demotion. I think he goes from being one of the strongest members of the team to one of the weakest. And also that cannon, I would love to see that cannon firing. That would be so cool. But maybe it would make the poster a little bit too busy. But speaking of a busy poster, I love that they put the names of the characters on the top there. That's great. They didn't put the actors. They put the names of the characters. And I think that's because, well, everybody knows, of course, who Batman and Wonder Woman are. I think for everybody else, even The Flash to some degree, not particularly well known to mainstream audiences. So when they're walking down again, I think this is very much a poster to put in the theater. So when you're in the multiplex and you're killing time before your show, before your movie starts, so when you get out and you stop and you look at this, because I think it's very eye-catching, you go, oh, who is everyone? Oh, I like their logos. And I just think it really draws you in. I'm very, very impressed with it. So that's why I love this poster. What do you think of it? What do you think of the lessons that DC is learning? Do you like how they're evolving as a brand? Or are you like, no, go back to the way it was? I did say I didn't want them to blink, but I would like them to also succeed. And to me, this is still, you know, with the exception of Batman wearing blue, to me, I think this still is very much what I would like to see. So write your own thoughts down below. And as always, you can check out some more videos right now.